Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I hope you're ready for a really powerful workout today. We're gonna try iron yoga or yoga with weights. This is a great way to strengthen the upper body really fast. So you will need a couple dumbbells. You don't really want them to be too heavy just because we are doing or holding them for a long time. So 5 pounds is more than enough, but feel free to reduce or go higher depending on what you'd like. So we're gonna keep them to the top of the mat and we're gonna begin in a wide-legged child's pose. Big toes together, knees apart. Instead of keeping our palms straight forward, we're gonna stretch into the upper back and triceps a little, just because this is a upper body intensive class. So press the hands together, bend the elbows, and reach your fingers towards the back of the neck. And we'll take a good 5 or so deep belly breaths here. Relaxing the belly. Breathing into the chest and shoulders. Take your last full deep breath here. And slowly straighten the arms.
Let's lift the chest back up, making our way into a tabletop pose for a few rounds of cat and cow. So nice and simple. On the inhale, drop the belly, lift the gaze, curl tailbone up. And as you exhale, round the spine, chin to chest. A few more, go at your own pace. Really focus on isolating this a little bit more in the upper part of your body, just because that's the one we're gonna be focusing on quite a bit today. And last one. Coming back to neutral. Let's take a few arm circles. So reach your right arm forward, up, back, and down. Do about 3 more or so. We're just trying to warm up the shoulders and get our full range of motion going, lubricating the joints. And let's set the right palm down, switch sides. So left fingertips forward, up, back, and down for 3 more. Keep breathing as you do this. All right, we are ready to get into our powerful workout. Please reach for your dumbbell with your right hand. Start to extend your left leg up and back. Keep your left thigh rolling down so the knee and the toes point down, and we're gonna reach our right arm forward. Take an inhale to extend, and as you exhale, pull the elbow and the knee together to touch and pull the dumbbell in close towards you. So inhale, lengthen and lift. Exhale, round and contract, pull it in close. 2 more, inhale, lift. Exhale, squeeze it in. Last one, inhale to extend. Drop the right dumbbell to the floor. You're gonna reach your right hand towards the back of the mat. Start to bend into your left knee, maybe catching a hold of the foot and pressing it into the palm. We're not really looking for a super deep back bend because we're just warming up the spine. Instead, focus on getting the quad stretch by reaching the knee towards the back of the mat. And let's release. Round the upper back a little bit, cat pose. And let's come back into our neutral tabletop stance, second side. So this time, right leg is gonna reach up and back. Keep rolling that thigh down and catch a hold of your weight in your left hand. As you inhale, reach the left arm up. Exhale, squeeze and pull it in. 3 more. So inhale, lengthen, strong arms. Exhale, squeeze it in, use your core. Lift on the inhale. Exhale, bring it in. Last one, inhale, reach. Release your dumbbell to the mat. Reach your left hand towards the right foot. Catch a hold of it and start to press it into the palm. Take another breath to lift the chest. And exhale, release, cat pose, round the upper back. Coming back to neutral, let's set up for a downward facing dog. So walk your palms a couple inches past the shoulders, curl the toes under, and then hips go up and back. So not everything we're gonna be doing will be using weights. We'll have a couple flows that focus exclusively on the abdominals, but we will try to incorporate the weights into our warrior poses and our lunges. Those are all really good places to add in some extra upper body strength, because normally our warrior poses focus a little bit more on the lower body and on the legs. So we're gonna even that out. So from this down dog, let's look forward. Take as many little steps as you need until the feet come forward to the top of the mat. Keep your feet about hip width distance apart or so, and just take your ragdoll fold. So relaxing the upper body over your thighs, bending the knees a little, maybe hold on to the elbows so you can sway. Soften the neck, shake out the head. Let's release our fingertips to the floor. Bend the knees a little more until you can bring your big toes together to touch and your heels about an inch apart or so. We're coming into chair pose. Grab a hold of your weights, bend the knees, drop the hips, and reach your arms up overhead. Biceps are along the ears, lower belly is hugging in. Bend your knees as much as you can. Rock the weight into your hips and into your heels. Take an inhale to lift. And as you exhale, bend the elbows, squeeze your shoulder blades behind you. Inhale, re-extend the arms up. Exhale to bend. Inhale, press up. Exhale to bend, last one. Inhale, lift. Exhale, bend the elbows. Let's fold forward, carefully drop the weights down. Relax your neck. Halfway lift, inhale, flat back. Exhale, fingertips to the floor, step the right foot back, lower the right knee down, and make your way into your low lunge. So arms lifting straight up. Tailbone is reaching down, hips are pressing forward and down until you get that nice stretch into your right hip flexors. Stay lifted, pulling out of the lower back. Making our way into our three-legged dog, let's plant the hands to the ground. You're gonna reach your left leg all the way up and back, bending the left knee and opening up that hip nice and wide. So we're going to integrate a little bit of core from here. Squeeze the glutes to lift your knee up a little higher. And then come to plank pose and tap your left knee towards the left outer arm. So all the way up to the armpit, and then cross it over to the right armpit. Then drop it to the right wrist, and then the left wrist. A few more times. So left armpit, right wrist, left wrist. Left armpit, right wrist, left wrist. Back into your three-legged dog. Keep it straight and squared. And let's come forward into our crescent lunge. Left foot in between the palms. Back heel is high off the mat. Catch a hold of your weights and lift up. Arms are along the ears. Left knee is bent, right knee might need to bend a little bit as well. Strong, steady breath. As you inhale, try to lengthen a little more. And on the exhale, we're gonna reach the arms back and lean forward at about a 45 degree angle. So long diagonal line. Lift the weights up more. Inhale, lift up, crescent lunge. Exhale, tilt it forward. Lift it back. Inhale, crescent lunge, last one. Exhale, hinge forward. Let's bring our hands to the center of the heart. So elbows are reaching out. Squeeze in and lift up to your warrior three. So you're standing on your left leg, right leg is extending up and back. Keep drawing your right hip down so the knee and the toes point down. Take another inhale to lengthen and carefully bring your right foot next to the left at the top of the mat. Big toes together, heels apart, bend the knees, drop the hips, reach the arms up overhead for chair pose. Rock the weight into the heels, take an inhale and then exhale, bend the elbows at a 90 degree angle. Inhale, press them back up. Exhale to bend. Inhale, lift. Exhale to lower. One more. Inhale, press it up. Exhale, release. Straighten the legs. Fold forward. Release the weights down. Take your halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, plant the palms. Step the left foot back. Lower the left knee down to the mat. We're coming right up into our low lunge. Try to slow down your breath. Feel the strength in the shoulders and the arms, even in a pose like this. And we meet in our three-legged dog. So palms come to the floor, right leg is gonna reach up and back. Bend your right knee and open up that hip. Feel the lower belly hug in. We're gonna engage our core. So come forward to plank pose and tap your right knee towards the right armpit. Really rock your weight forward and then tap over to the left armpit, left wrist, right wrist. Coming up, right armpit, left wrist, right wrist. Right armpit, left wrist, right wrist, three-legged dog. Straighten squared, we step it forward to our crescent lunge. Feet are hip width distance apart. Catch a hold of the dumbbells and come up, reaching your arms up overhead. Strong upper body. So your core helps support you. Keep the stability as you inhale, lift and lengthen. And on the exhale, hinge forward, reach the palms back, lift it up and engage your shoulder blades. Inhale, lift up. And exhale, tilt it forward. Inhale, reach it up. Exhale, hinge forward. Keep bending into your right knee. Let's bring our hands at our heart. Elbows are out. Stand on the right leg. We're coming into warrior three. Left leg is extending up and back. So you're not dipping your chest too low. Keep your gaze steady. Take another breath to lengthen. And let's come all the way up to stand. Big toes together. Heels apart. Release the arms by your side. Mountain pose. Draw the tailbone down. Tuck the chin in towards the chest. All right, from here, let's make our way into warrior two. So keep your left foot forward and step the right leg back. You want your right foot to be parallel to the short edge of your mat. You're bending into your left knee and pressing your left knee open. Now reach the arms out. So it won't take too long before this pose really starts to work the upper body. Even engaging muscles along the spine, the erectors, strengthening your back. So turn your palms to face forward. As you inhale, lengthen. And on the exhale, bend the elbows and bring your palms in towards your chest. Keep bending into the left knee. So as you inhale, open up. And then exhale, bring it in. Keep the elbows lifted as much as you can. Inhale to open. Exhale, bring it in. Inhale, open it up. Let's bring our left forearm over our left thigh. Reach your right arm straight up towards the sky. So this is a variation of our extended side angle. We're not gonna extend it too much. Instead, focus on bending the left knee and dropping the hips. Start to look down at the floor, and you're gonna bend into that right elbow until you can bring the weight down. Lift your back heel off the floor, come back into that lunge, tilting forward, reaching both arms back. Squeeze the shoulder blades behind you, and let's slowly bring the weights down to the floor. Find your downward facing dog. So inhale in your down dog, exhale, press into it. Taking your flow, inhale to plank pose. Exhale, maybe chaturanga, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, hips lift up and back to your downward facing dog. Let's make our way to the top of the mat. Lift your heels, bend your knees, step or hop forward. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, release. Catch a hold of your blocks, bend the knees generously, and slowly roll all the way up. Head and shoulders are the last to make their way there. Find your mountain pose. Close the eyes, slow down the breath. Warrior two on the second side. Keep your right foot where it is. Step the left leg back. You want to bend your right knee generously and bring your left foot parallel to the short edge of your mat. We're here for five breaths. Reach the arms out. As you bend your right knee, try to press that right knee open a little bit more. Keep your shoulders over the top of your hips. Keep them lifted on the inhale. And as you exhale, just turn the palms forward, bend the elbows, and bring the hands in towards the chest. So on an inhale, we open up wide. And on the exhale, we bend the elbows and bring it in. Inhale, open up. Exhale to bend. Last one. Inhale, lift. Exhale, bend the elbows. Set your right forearm to your thigh. Left arm up towards the sky. So a different way of doing your extended side angle. Keep trying to drop the hips down low. Bending into the right knee, pressing to the outer edge of your foot. Looking wherever is comfortable for your neck. Start to look down towards the floor. You're gonna drop your left arm down to the mat. Pick up your left heel off the ground and reach both arms back, palms facing down. High lunge with a tilt. Bend the right knee even more. Sink the hips a little lower, reach the crown of the head forward. And let's set the weights to the mat. Meet back in downward facing dog. One full breath cycle in this down dog. Really press the chest towards the thighs. Feel the strength you're cultivating there in the shoulders and upper back, biceps and triceps. And we'll take our vinyasa. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Let's bring our knees to the floor. Lower down onto your forearms. We're gonna make our way into dolphin pose. So you want your palms and your elbows to be about shoulder width distance apart, no more, no less. Planting into the fingertips, curl the toes under, lift back up. Walk the toes in a little bit. Keep the crown of the head lifting off the floor. See if you can reach your chest towards your thighs a little more. Let's lift our heels off the ground. Reach your right leg up as high as you can. Try to keep the shoulders even. Reach through the legs, squeeze the glutes, engage the hamstrings. Let's set the right foot down, switch sides, left leg up. Try not to collapse in the chest. Stay super strong, lift, lift, lift. And let's release, walk the feet back, lower your hips down to the ground, coming up into Sphinx pose. Forearms to the ground, just lift your chest, pull the shoulders back. Breathe deeply. And let's release down. Make your way back into your downward facing dog. Curl the toes under, lift your hips up and back. From this downward facing dog, let's reach our right leg up and back. And carefully step it forward in between your palms. We're coming back into that lunge. So grab a hold of your weights and lift on up. Biceps are along the ears. From here, you're gonna bring your knuckles in together to touch. So keeping everything pretty close together, squeezing the biceps along the ears, still bending into your right knee so the hips can drop down low. And you're gonna bend the elbows and reach the weights towards the back of your neck. So inhale, lift and press them back up. And then exhale to bend and drop them down. Inhale, lift. Exhale, release. Inhale, lift up. Exhale to lower. Last one. Inhale, lift up. Let's open the arms straight out to the sides, and we're gonna come into a twist. So reach the arms open, left arm forward, right hand back. Still bending into your right knee, so the hips drop down. Stay lifted through the chest, inhale. Coming into our easy twist, so left hand and left weight to the ground, right arm up. Looking to the floor, release the right hand, drop the weights to the mat. Let's take our vinyasa. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Second side, left leg up. Step it through, crescent lunge. Grab a hold of your weights, lift on up. Bend the left knee, make sure both hips are facing forward towards the top of the mat. Bring your knuckles in towards each other, lift up tall. And then exhale, bend the elbows, reach the weights towards the back of your neck. So a good stretch and good strength. Inhale, lift back up. Exhale to bend. Inhale, straighten the arms. Exhale to lower, two more. Last one, inhale, lift. Exhale, release. Let's reach the arms straight out to the sides and open it up to a twist. Right arm forward, left hand back. Still bending deeply into your left knee. Get your obliques involved in this twist. Pull the lower belly in. And let's take our easy twist, right hand down, left arm up. Looking down to the floor, set the left hand to the mat, take your flow. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. So we'll do some bicep curls next. I'll start with the left side, just because that's the side facing the camera and I want you to be able to see it. So let's reach our left leg up. And then step that left leg forward in between your hands. Bring your right foot parallel to the short edge of your mat, so you're coming up to warrior two. Depending on your strength, maybe use one weight, maybe use two. I'm gonna do it with one to start off with. So the weight will go in your left hand, arms reach out. And let's take extended side angle. So bring your left forearm over your left thigh, and you can bring your right hand just on your hip. So we're gonna do our bicep curls from here. Keep bending the left knee, drop the hips down low, and you need to bring your elbow forward on the thigh a little bit, so not to the back. Give yourself some space, use your core to hold you in the pose. So start to open up the arm, and then exhale to bring it in. So if you wanted to make this more challenging, you're gonna grab both weights. So as you inhale, you straighten, and then exhale, you bend it in. I'm just gonna keep going with one. So let's do three more. Inhale, you open. Exhale, contract. Inhale, open. Bring it in. Last one. Looking down to the floor, set the weight to the mat, downward dog. Second side, right leg up. Step your right foot forward in between the palms, spin your back heel parallel to the short edge of your mat. Grab either one or both weights. Come up into your warrior two. So the weight is in your right hand, left arm is extending back, and we're gonna come into our extended side angle. So right forearm, or right elbow, I should say, over the right thigh, left hand on your waist. Choose if you're gonna do one or two weights. As you inhale, straighten the arm. Exhale, do your bicep curl. Four more, go at your own pace, as slow as you need to. Stay connected to your breath. So every time you inhale, you open. As you exhale, you contract. Keep dropping the hips down nice and low. About two more. And let's look down on the ground. Set the weight to the floor. Step back into your downward facing dog. And before we take our vinyasa, let's make sure our feet are hip-width distance apart. We're gonna shift forward into our plank pose. Let's drop both heels to the right. Lean on your right hand, extend your left arm up. So taking your side plank, press into the feet to lift the hips up higher. And let's move to the other side. So left hand down, drop your heels to the left side, reach your right arm up. Let's come down on our right forearm. Right forearm plank, so heels go right again. Left arm up. Side forearm plank to the left. Left forearm to the ground, heels to the left. Right arm reaches up, only looking up if that's okay for your neck. And let's bring both forearms down to the ground. Lift your heels. We're coming back to dolphin. Reach the hips up as high as you can. Press your chest to your thighs. Pull the stomach in. So from this dolphin pose, let's make our way into chaturanga. So you need to look forward, press into the fingertips and knuckles, keep the elbows bent, just rock the weight forward, lower chaturanga, inhale up dog, exhale downward facing dog. And let's set our knees to the floor, move the weights out of the way, we won't be needing them anymore. And we'll take puppy pose to release that. So keep your hips over your knees, walk the palms forward, and bring the forehead to the ground. Get a nice stretch. Breathe into the chest and upper back. Let's walk our palms back in. Swing your legs forward. We're gonna come into knee pile pose with eagle arms to help open up the upper body a little bit more. So starting to cool off our practice, focusing on stretching rather than strengthening. So you're gonna pile your right knee, stacking it directly over the top of the left. So if that doesn't necessarily work for your hips, you can just stay cross-legged. That's perfectly fine too. Otherwise, one knee is over the other. The heels are close in towards you. Bending the elbows at a 90 degree angle. Let's swing our right arm underneath our left, binding once or binding twice. Spread the shoulder blades nice and wide. Draw the shoulders away from the ears. Press the forearms together and bring your chin towards your chest. If you'd like to take this further, you're gonna hinge at the hips and fold down. Let's come all the way back up, unwrap the arms, and let's switch sides. Left knee over the right. Heels come close in towards the glutes. Sit up nice and tall, elbows bent. This time it's left arm underneath your right, binding once or twice. Draw the shoulder blades down the back, lift the elbows, palms away from you. Start to tuck the chin to the chest. Choose to stay here or fold at the waist and lower down. Coming back up. So one last stretch for the chest and upper body. Bring your palms back behind you, feet flat to the ground. You're gonna spread the fingertips nice and wide. Keep your palms roughly underneath your shoulders and then pick up your hips and shift them closer towards your heels. Keep the elbows bent and try to bring your elbows in towards one another while lifting the chest up towards the sky. So this is one of my favorite stretches to do.
helps get really deep into the shoulder, opens up the chest a little. Everyone tends to feel this one a little differently. Just depends on where you hold tightness. Take another breath. And let's straighten the legs, lower and make your way down. Coming into Shavasana, our final resting pose. Taking up some space with the arms and the legs, allowing the eyes to close. And observe the effects your practice has had on your body, especially noticing what it's done to the upper body. You might find that the shoulders and arms are still buzzing a little, still feel energized. Allow yourself to soften into this final pose, letting go of the need to work, and instead just enjoying the relaxation and the rest. I encourage you to stay here for as long as you would like. This is where I will leave you. Thank you so much for doing this practice with me. I hope that you will subscribe to my channel. And if you enjoyed iron yoga, let me know. I can always make more and post them up here on my YouTube channel for you guys. Have a fantastic day. Namaste.